Tommaso Mansi. I'm senior director at Siemens Healthineers in Princeton, New Jersey, leading the team focusing on image-guided therapy and robotics. We focus on developing technologies to support interventional planning, guidance, monitoring, and follow-up. Heart failure is one of the most significant burden in terms of healthcare. During the process of the disease, as the heart becomes bigger and sick, these two chambers actually beat asynchronously. So the idea of cardiac resynchronization therapy is to actually overwrite the electrical asynchrony using an advanced pacemaker. The idea is to put electrodes on the right and on the left, right? And then time it correctly such that we resynchronize the heart. And if it's placed well and the patient responds, the quality of life of the patient increases significantly. The problem is that there are patients who still do not respond, about 30 to 50% depending on the statistics. So the question is this, so how can we adjust the therapy to increase the chance that he's gonna respond? Here is the idea of, okay, why not actually creating that digital twin and trying the different configurations on the computer, provide some suggestions of what could potentially work or not, and then use that information, use that knowledge to guide the intervention. So now creating a digital twin, this is a bold vision, right? We are talking about creating a digital twin of a human body, of a human heart, right? So, and this requires a lot of expertise from different fields. We really have a multidisciplinary team working all very, very closely together, including a physician, Dr. Hiroshi Ashikaga, who really guides us in what are the real clinical problems that such a technology could help. So if we take cardiac physiology, right? So you have mechanics, electrophysiology, fluid dynamics, the blood flow inside and so on. So these are very specific physiologies, each one with its own laws. What is interesting is that there are not that many laws in nature, right? So the mathematical structure of these equations can often be similar, even though they represent different physiologies or different physics. And so it's the same approach, the same thinking, the same philosophy, understand nature, try to approximate it through mathematical laws, adjust with data to predict what will happen. And this applies to many aspects, right? Cosmology with the galaxies, weather, what weather will be tomorrow, or for the heart, for the liver, for the human body, it's always the same principle.